Well, it's 20 to 8. We're in the queue for Inglourious Basterds. And these lovely people have just opened the gates and are about to let us in. Hey! Let's see what Damo thinks. He was on set. Let's see if we can find him in this crowd somewhere. Ooh! Damo! I liked it.
I fucking loved it.
Yeah. I haven't just hit a wall. The wall is actively fighting back. Nevertheless, I'm not going to relax just yet. I'm here at the Orange Beach. I'm going to interview Glenn Ficarra and John Requa, directors of I Love You, Philip Morris, a fantastic new comedy starring Jim Carrey and Ewan McGregor. But first, you know, I'm going to start thinking of really, really tough questions to ask him. Really hard-hitting stuff.
Not in our wildest dreams.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was actually our producer, Andrew, who really had the flight of fancy to think that we can get Jim for this. And he said yes immediately. It was like, it was unbelievable. The movie just fell together. Same with Ewan, too.
Yeah.
It's like, well, like you said to Jim, who do you want to be this part? And we were thinking Ewan McGregor would be great. And he says, well, how about Ewan McGregor? We're like, okay. And then we sent it out to Ewan, and Ewan said yes. And that was it. You know, it's just like, it just doesn't happen that easily.
Yeah, tip to struggling filmmakers. You want to get your independent movie made. Just get Jim Carrey and Ewan McGregor to star in it, and you, boom,
you're off
you
to the
got
races.
It.
One of my favorite bits in the film was the reveal that Stephen is gay,
mm-hmm.
Along with the anal sex joke in Bad Santa. Are you guys now the king of the,
you know,
the anal sex guy?
You're the first person to notice it.
We said,
oh, we're gonna get so nailed for this,
yeah,
because you know of Bad Santa and this, and it was just, I don't know, it just sort of happened.
Yeah, I've been accused of having a bit of an anal fixation, but
you know, we just like,
you know,
we,
very
we like
Freudian
to
put, thing. I guess
we like to push buttons.
Yeah. The greatest anal sex jokes in the history of cinema.
Yeah, and we own both of them.
Yeah.
We own Boardwalk and Park Place, man.
Any plans for a trilogy?
Yeah.
Hopefully. You never know.
Hopefully.
Fisting isn't far behind.
Marvin Gardens.
Well, readers, I'm very excited. I've got the hottest ticket in town right here. It's for the Inglourious Basterds party. Look at that, at the Beoli Beach. It's going to be amazing. Quentin Tarantino's going to be there. Brad Pitt's going to be there. My old director, Eli Roth's going to be there. It's going to be absolutely.
Have you seen my ticket anywhere?
No. What?
I think this is it.
No, it's fine. It's fine, Damon. It's fine. Damon, no, it's mine. Damon.
No, this is my ticket. I'm sorry. It's my ticket.
You have a great time, Damon, yeah? Have a great time.
Mine!
Aha! Made it to the party after all. In your face, Damon. In your face. Mind you, this isn't actually a party ticket, and Damo is inside with his old buddy Quentin, munching on canapes. Still, I'm not jealous, because Quentin and the gang came along this red carpet just a few minutes ago, and we spoke to loads of them. So we're going to leave you now with the soothing strains of some typically hard-hitting Empire interviews.
How much did it change over the years when you first had the idea?
Well, it changed drastically. I came up with a lot of the same characters, and there's a few sequences that are the same from what I wrote a long time ago, but I had a completely different storyline. And that was the majority of what I wrote, was this other story.
Okay.
And so, and it got just too big and too unwieldy. It was a miniseries. It wasn't a movie. And so when I came back to it, I took that story away and came up with a new story.
Can you talk about this prequel that you might be doing? Or?
Well, that could be the stuff that I'd written for the other story. I like the other story. It was just too big, but now I've used some of it, so now it would be the right length. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
You know, it's almost like old school Tarantino, but with more weight and more mature. Because it's like Pulp Fiction, it's like Reservoir Dogs, it's like Jackie Brown, but it has maturity. It's got the comedy and the violence and the wonderful storytelling.
How did he pitch it to you?
He said, what are you doing? I need you to come to Germany with me and start a movie with Brad Pitt. And I went, all right.
It was a pretty scary shoot. It was a fire drill. After each time he yelled cut, everyone had to leave the building.
Never. No, this is his world, and I was happy to be one of his brushes in his painting. It was just a joy.
You know, obviously born in Germany, I understand. I understand German, but speaking it, I'm a bit rusty, you know, so yeah, that was probably where... Well, definitely where most of the work went in, sort of trying to get that walking around with the Walkman on, trying to make sure I was I was stepping on dresses left, right, and center here.
Awesome! Awesome!
Well, well, well.
Awesome!
Well, well, well.
You can get a pinky. There you go.